Hey guys, welcome to Automation Club and let's continue to learn on Protector TypeScript framework designing. So in last video we created a test script for framework designing, and in this video we'll implement page object model. So page object model is a design pattern which is used in any automation framework to create object repository for web UI elements. So whatever elements coming on web UI, so we'll try to maintain those elements on page wise. So how it is actually, let me show you. So for example, this is a web application. Okay, so once we launch it, we'll get a home page. So on home page you can see there are two elements, customer login and bank manager login. So we'll create a home page. Okay, we'll keep these two elements on that page, the elements from home page on home page separate page. Okay, so once we'll click on bank manager login, we'll get another page where we have three options: add customer, open account, customers. So these are the elements on another page, and for that we'll create a separate page. So if we'll click on add customer, we'll get these options are nothing but elements from another page. So this page means these elements from this page will keep it separate. So maintaining these elements on page wise is a mechanism which is called as a page object model. So advantage of this is in the framework is like it will reduce your code duplication and it will improve the test maintenance as well. So it will be very easy to maintain our test script, and in real project when there are some changes in UI or some changes in XPath or something like that in locators, so it is very easy to maintain and to do the maintenance work. Okay, so this is the script which we created in last video, so we'll try to convert it into page object model. Okay, so let's do that. So we'll create a folder and name it as a page object, page objects. Okay, and first we will create for home page. So inside it, just create a home page dot ts file. So this file will have elements from home page. Okay, so create a class home. Okay, so on home page what you can see, there are two elements, customer login and bank manager login. Okay, so button customer, so this is the standard, like for button you should use btn as a prefix. Okay, so as per your project guidelines you can use that. So button customer login. Okay, so what is the return type of it? Element finder, element finder. So as we are working on TypeScript, so where we need to give the type of element. Okay, so button customer login, then button manager login, again it is element finder. Okay, and we'll give a locator of it in a constructor. So for that, constructor, and now we will initialize it by its locator. This dot button customer login equals, so we'll not create a locator because already we do have, which we created in our previous video. So this is the locator for bank manager login. I think we need to create for customer login. Okay, the start button manager login. So if you are not familiar with the constructor class and this operator, so please refer my previous video on TypeScript basics. So there I have explained these terms. Okay, so button manager login, so we'll simply paste it. Okay, so see the error is coming. So what you have to do, you have to import element by, okay, from protector element finder, already it is there. So for customer login, let's create that. So we will use button text. Element by dot button text. Fine. So we have created a home class where we have kept two elements. One is customer login, another is manager login. We have initialized it by its locator inside a constructor. So this is ready. Now this page or this class will be used in some script, right? So we need to export it because we need to import in somewhere else. So again, this is the term from TypeScript, and I have explained this in my previous video of TypeScript basics. So you can refer those video to learn on this. So export class home. So what I will do, I will go to my test script, and in this script I need to import those class and elements, right? So import home, we need to give the class name what we have given there, home, right? So import it. So import home from, we need to give the path. So it is under page object and then homepage.ts file. So I have imported it, and now after importing, I need to use the method or elements from that class, right? So for that, we need to create an object of it. So create object. For creating object, left object home equal new operator we will use the class name. Okay, so we have created a object of it, and now we will replace our locator in our object inside the script to with the object which we are taking it from the page object. So manager login, right? So replace it. Await this dot. Object home dot. No need to use this because we are inside describe and it block. So object home dot. See, after giving dot, there are two options coming: button customer login and button manager login. So these are the elements coming from that page. Okay, because we have imported and we have created an object of it. So choose manager login dot. What operation we want to perform here? Click. Okay, and now delete this. So this script we created in our last video of framework, okay, where we kept all the elements inside spec.ts. So we have removed it. Fine. So after clicking on Bank Manager login, we'll get this page. So again create another page and give name like new file, add customer dot ts class add customer. This dot. So what are the options? Add customer. Sorry, we need to give the name of element, right? Button add customer. Equals. Not equal. Type of it, which is element finder. Next one is open account, or let it be. So we'll try to have the elements from add customer itself. So on our add customer, we'll have first name, last name, and postcode and add customer button. So we'll try to create object of it. Okay. Then edit box. For edit box, generally prefix is used as EDT. So this is the coding standard, and it may differ project wise. Okay, so EDT first name, again element finder. Then we have last name, postcode, that is again edit box, postcode. And add customer button. So button add customer. Give something else, login. Fine. Element finder. So these five elements from this page. Initialize by its locators. For that, what we'll do, we'll create a constructor, and inside it just initialize this elements. This dot button add customer will not create a locator or XPath, will directly take it from the script, because already we have created in last video. So I don't want to spend time in creating the locators. Okay, so directly copy it. So this is add customer option. Let me make sure of it. Button class one. Okay, it is correct one. Let's copy it. This dot first name. So what is locator of first name? Element by dot model. Okay. We will try to make our test script very simple, so that it will be very easy to maintain, and even will reduce the code duplicacy. So this dot edt last name, copy it, fine. Then what we have, post code, locator of post code, so just try to understand the concept here, what we are doing actually. Okay, submit button. So this is for add customer, I think. Yeah, this dot button customer, instead of login give it submit, this dot button add customer element, instead of it paste it simply. Okay, so here you can see error in by element has come, so add by as well in import, and then error will be gone. Okay, so what we have done, we have created another class add customer. Okay, so suppose it is a page, and on that page we have added elements whatever coming on that page. Okay, and we have initialized their locators. Okay, so go to a script and replace it by its objects. Okay, already we have created object of that class, so simply what we will do, object home dot. Okay, so for the second class we have to create object, right? So import it, and before import what we need to do, export that class, then it will be available to import in some other file. So export it, and like we did for home, right, similarly do it for next page. Import, what is the class name, add customer, from, and now we have to give the path, page object, and inside that add customer. This is the file name. Okay, don't confuse between the file name and class name. Now we need to create object of it. Let object customer, so equal new, and what is the class name, add customer. Okay, and also do not confuse where I am using let and where I am not using it. Suppose in class I am not using it directly, I have given the element name without using let or where. Why? Because here I am inside the class already, I am in between of some foundation. Okay, inside it will be under class only. Okay, scope will not be outside of this class. So already I have added these elements inside a class, so that's why there is no need of using let. And here I have created two objects, and for that I have used let to declare it, because here I am not inside any class. Okay, now we will use these objects dot, what we need to do, add customer, right, dot click, then remove it because this is of no use now. Similarly, use it for first name, last name. Okay, so object customer dot first name dot send keys, give the name test one. Similarly, use it for second name, edit is last name dot send keys test two. Next, we do have postcode. Dot send keys and give some random postcode because this is dummy application. Just we need to understand the concept. Okay, so remove it. And then we have to click on add customer submit. So object customer dot add customer submit, and here we need to click it, correct? Just remove it, and to ensure the sync, just use await before every line of code. Await. Okay, so what we have done so far, let me summarize. So I have created a page objects file, and inside that two files have been created. One is homepage.ts, another is addcustomer.ts. On homepage.ts, I have created and I have added the elements whatever coming on homepage, and I have initialized those elements by their locators. And on the next page, addcustomer, I have created elements on from the add customer page, okay, and given the locators inside constructor. Fine. And for making use of this page or this class in some other file, we need to use export and import keywords, and after that we'll create object, and then we'll be able to use their elements. Okay, so this is the test script now, and just see how cool it is looking now. Earlier, inside spec.ts only, we had all the locators and everything, but now just we have the elements name. Okay, so let it be, and we'll try to compile and run it. Okay, so let's compile it. Before it, let me see the configuration file. Okay, it is looking fine to me. And here direct connect, then no need to start the server. Directly we will run it. So this is a alert code to handle the alert, which we did in our previous video, and we validated the message from the alert. So okay, it is fine, and then we'll try to compile and run it. TSC to compile the TypeScript code, and then protector. So our configuration.js file is inside JS files folder, right? So give that JS files, then configuration dot JS, run it. So it is opening the web page, practice protector practice website, and added all the details. And customer edit successfully. Okay. To see it, let me add some weight. Browser dot sleep. Intentionally, I am adding this static weight just to see the execution. Browser dot sleep. So this is the static weight, which is not a good practice, but just to see the execution, we are using it. Convert it into JavaScript and then run it. So it launch the URL, bank manager login, add customer, test 1, test 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 in postcode, and then add customer. Okay, so it's done. So I think something problem on their application, means after clicking on add customer, all the fields are getting erased. So that is not our scope to look into it. Okay, so yeah, that's it. Like to understand the page object model concept in Protector automation framework. So this is how we can create a page object model, and we can keep all the elements on page wise. So this is just a demo and to understand this concept in the framework, and which is very much important in terms of code reusability and removing the code duplicacy. Also, it will be very easy, and it is means to maintain the script and framework. Okay, so yeah, that's it for this video. For any doubt, you can just contact me on through my email, which I will give in description. Okay, thanks a lot. Thanks for watching. Thank you.